You're the only power. You're the only power.
Work, can you? CSU!
Work, work!
Let's go, boys. Let's go.
If you're Metro, don't trust you. I'm gonna shoot you.
Beautiful morning. Yeah, the sun in my morning, babe.
March 24th, a beautiful evening in northern Colorado. You can see the gorgeous shots from our crew. It's a marquee night in the Rocky Mountain Lacrosse Conference. We're on campus in Fort Collins, walking you up to a top 25 face-off between Colorado State and Utah Valley. My name's Marty Cesario, along with Phil Mildren and a super talented production crew. We are getting ready for some MCLA action at the back end of the regular season. The Wolverines rank 16th in the MCLA, playing their first of two on the road trip over here into the Front Range in Colorado. The Rams rank 21st in the country, working with the momentum of consecutive wins over number 22 Florida State on Saturday, and then that commanding victory over Washington on Monday. So coming up, nationally ranked squads. It's a big game in Mountain Time. We've got college lacrosse from Fort Collins here on FanView, featuring Colorado State and Utah Valley. Taking a peek at some of the Colorado State men's lacrosse faithful who are here to support their LAC squad. And there's a look at the Rammies and their impact players. Three guys that are on our radar before we begin this contest between two top 25 squads. Matthew Doughton, what a stud, the freshman. He's played only six games. He's got 12 points, including seven goals. He scored four against Washington just 3 days ago. Cale Kissel does so much as a long pole for that CSU squad. And then Noah Miller, the local kid out of the Denver East program, does so much on the back end in front of the starter, Dylan Widows. And when we look at Utah Valley and players that kind of have our attention as we just get going here, certainly Preston Burbage is going to be one of those guys. 34 points, he's got 17 goals as a senior out of Salt Lake. Another attackman out of Pleasant Grove, Utah, is Chad Renslow. So up front, Utah Valley strong. And then keep an eye on D-man Remington Peterson out of Sandy, Utah, another senior who plays for head coach Brian Barnhill. And when we think of the head coaches, well, first of all, there's Ryan McDonald, who does so much for this program. He's an alum. He's invested. He's got a national championship. He's a former All-American. He's a disciple of Flip Nomberg. And here he has his squad sitting at 7-2 in conference, an important game within the MCLA. That is head coach Ryan McDonald, his fifth year as the leader for Colorado State men's lacrosse and for Utah Valley. Well, their head guy has been around too, and you're looking at him right there, Brian Barnhill, seventh year as the leader for the Utah Valley program. And right now he's got his team at 5-1 overall. They're riding the momentum of a three overtime victory over then 21st ranked Cal Poly. Just one loss on the season. Both these squads looking for prime positioning as we are in the back end of the Rocky Mountain Lacrosse Conference season. And we are approaching that RMLC scheduling. Let's go ahead and look at scheduling. When you look at the recent games for Colorado State, that commanding victory on this turf right here just 3 days ago on Monday, the Rams scored the first six goals in the game and then just maintained that lead throughout the rest of the contest. You got that big win over number 22 Florida State. on Saturday. And then the blemish is the Texas loss. That was down on that Texas road trip. Got the win against A&M, but took that loss in conference against Texas. And that's why we're leading into this very critical and important contest against Utah Valley. And when we speak of the Wolverines of Utah Valley and look at their recent five games, you look at their marquee win is that win over Cal Poly. They also have a victory over then number 23 Dominican out of California. Their lone loss is to a top 10 squad in Santa Clara. You see those victories in state against the Aggies of Utah State and then Southern Utah as well. So we got really strong programs with outstanding resumes, and it is push come to shove time. Both these squads are going to find out. Each of them have top-ranked BYU ahead of them in the Rocky Mountain Lacrosse Conference schedule. But that's looking ahead. Right now, that's the litmus test. This is a watershed moment for each of them as we get ready for the opening face-off here with FanView. We'll stand by for the face-off. Looking over the top and to the west here in northern Colorado. Sun's about to set as we get ready for this face-off between Utah Valley and Colorado State. Right now we're presenting the coin toss as you see the officiating crew and then each of the squad's captains out there giving the sportsmanlike pounds to each other, and we'll get a read on who's going to get awarded possession to get things going, and then we'll get that opening face-off going. So we'll take a quick break. We are approaching the face-off between Utah Valley, 16th ranked in the country, and your number 21 Colorado State Rams. Stand by. Looking at the Colorado State Rams breaking huddle with their squad and getting ready to go. That's Dylan Widows. What a good story it is for him to even be here. He was injured. Stopped a shot against Washington and took it in the wrong spot. Went off the field, pulled himself, and here he is all healthy and ready to go. 35 right there in the foreground will be the starter in goal for Colorado State. Since I'm talking about goaltenders for Utah Valley, it'll be the freshman Mac Sturgill, a 6-foot, 170-pounder out of Utah, who will begin things in the cage for the guys in the dark jerseys. Visual setup for you once again. Utah Valley wearing the green helmets and the dark tops and shorts. Colorado State, I like that they're trimmed in the Aggie pumpkin. Nice little effect there for them. A little bravado, gamesmanship. And then they are wearing the white jerseys with the white shorts, and then, of course, the familiar green lids with the iconic Ram Bighorn Curl. Just getting started at 7:02 Mountain Time as you get those beautiful shots from Bill Mildren and his crew. Utah State at Colorado State within the top 25. Here we go. Opening faceoff win for CSU. Cole Kober starting off the offensive set for CSU, and we have whistles blown. All the shots, including that one that you're enjoying from Phil Mildren, our producer, and production lead Justin Salvia is our director on the technical. Johnny Houston back there in the production truck, what I'm calling it, Zach Johnson, Mike Trujillo, providing you the camera visuals here on a beautiful night at 59 degrees, just about at dusk here in northern Colorado. And now we're underway, just about 30 seconds in, after the discussion with the officiating crew. We should note, and applause to them, this officiating staff were involved in a car accident before this game, still made it right on time, so good for them. Thought that was a turnover, not the case. CSU is going to maintain possession. Again, Utah Valley in black with the green helmets. CSU has possession, white with the Ram green helmets. As you see, that pass to the interior is off, and a quick clear by Utah Valley sprinting forward for Utah Valley was 44 Patrick Fletcher. And now we see the first true possession for Utah Valley, moving from right to left. Retreating is Chad Renslow, one of our featured players out of Pleasant Grove, Utah, senior with 21 goals, 28 total points on the season. Bouncing forward is Nathan Huntsman. Center cutter coming in, receives cleanly, but excellent defensive reaction by Cale Kissel, knocking the ball loose. Utah Valley's going to chase it, and that'll be a turnover. So excellent defense for CSU. I thought a really clean shot on goal was coming for Utah Valley. Not the case. Credit Kissel and the defenders for the Rams. Colorado State ranked 21 in the latest Men's Collegiate Lacrosse Association poll. Utah Valley 16th in the country. Malcolm McDonald inside. And before he could get a shot off, he was double-teamed and the ball was knocked loose. So Sturgill sends it to his D-men. And here comes Remington Pearson shooting it across to Keaton Stevens, and Utah Valley clears successfully. Just over 2 minutes into this first quarter. We got a long way to go in what should be very tight, evenly matched, competitive lacrosse contests with outstanding players. Kimball Matheny over the near wing, and now he's going to yield and send it back up top. That's Nate Huntsman getting a shot off. It does not get through. We're going to call that a save for Dylan Widows as you get that tight shot from Nate Huntsman, who played at Windsor. He's a local kid. His parents are here, including his dad, Mark, and the family. We're scoreless. Utah Valley is being very aggressive. You look on screen, multiple players with the full ride, a 10-man ride, as I'm getting intel coming in. Thanks, Sully. I've got my sources. So Utah Valley, if you watch, one adjustment here for head coach Brian Barnhill is when CSU's trying to clear, you've got a lot of activity on the ride, trying to keep CSU from clearing. Right now it's Utah Valley with possession. They get one shot off. It wraps around the charging Malcolm McDonald and is wide of the cage, so not much threat there to Dylan Widows. Again, Dylan Widows, the outstanding sophomore, is in goal tonight for CSU. That's a great thing. What we've learned throughout the course of the season, multiple goaltenders available, but it's Widows who's the gamer. Those notable wins over Georgia and Florida State. Widows has been in goal. And Utah Valley able to get a score right there. So popping the cork on the board for Utah Valley is Connor Boss. Pardon me, it was Chad Renslow as you look at the replay. So we'll mark it down at the 11-10 mark in the first quarter. 22, Chad Renslow scores for Utah Valley, and the Wolverines have a 1-0 lead. Here comes Cole Colber and Colorado State. Good exchanges, and that shot is swept to the near side successfully by Max Sturgill. CSU is going to keep it. McFerrin back there. Sends it up high to Colbert. McAnally from the top. Down to X and McFerrin. We'll see where Jared wants to place this. Instead, he takes the shot just crossing the GLE. So just past the goal line. Got a shot off. And that was wide. And now Utah Valley's going to try to clear. Here comes Remington Pearson. So it's Remington Peterson with the good clear, and Utah Valley setting up with their 1-0 lead. Chad Renslow at 11-10 here in this first quarter has scored for Utah Valley, and now the Wolverines have possession again. Ball down. Ground ball pickup with momentum. Jake Niss. And here comes the Rams. Nick Chastain, one of the top goal scorers for the Rams, sending it down low. This is a good look if you're a Rams fan. Ryan Springer is out there on the field. He's missed a couple of games, had some injury issues. Despite missing a couple of games, he's one of the top five scorers for the CSU men's lacrosse program. 99 is out there just on the far side of the cage when we go to the wider shot. That is a good look. Ryan Springer is out there. Colbert swimming through multiple defenders. That pass attempt is off. That'll be a turnover. Long throw to center line. Utah Valley tries to save it. And instead it's a turnover. Nifty trading there. Flores with the shot, and it's wide. Went for the bounce attempt to the far side. Couldn't get it through, and Utah Valley's going to get it. I wanted to finish off that highlight call. Started with a scoop shot from underneath, and Flores received it on the run, but Rams could not score, and now they have to defend. Physical defense from Cale Kissel, number 10 right there, the long pole. And now Utah Valley retreats. That's Nate Huntsman up top, their sophomore middie out of Windsor. One goal, that was 3 minutes ago. Chad Renslow at the 11-10 mark. Utah Valley with the dark unis have the one goal lead. You hear the Utah Valley bench groan after that shot attempt. That came from Braden Hudson, the freshman from Woods Cross, Utah. Ground ball center line. McFerrin scoops it up, but then a whistle blown. And we have a pause in the action about 7 minutes into this opening quarter. Again, you get those great visuals from Zach Johnson and Mike Trujillo. The resilient officiating crew, enduring an auto accident before face-off, still got here on time. Probably they're like us, where we knew what kind of game this was. We got top 25s. We got to get there. Sorry, officer, I just don't have the time. I'm looking around to see perhaps the police came along for the ride. We did the lax. Who's playing? Oh, we're in. Low to high shot attempt is off. That came off the stick of Tyler Hawes. Dylan Widows in goal for CSU. And that one goes wide of him on the far side. Widows was going to try chase it down there, and he is unsuccessful. So a lengthy possession here with 1-0 lead for Utah Valley. Another shot attempt for the Wolverines, and they're going to keep it as we look in on Dylan Widows. Trying to make Widows move from side to side, and he's game. Widows with the save. protecting his pipes. Good job, Dylan. Now, and here's that ride that Patrick Sullivan was talking about. CSU having problems clearing, and Utah Valley forces the turnover. We will have to see how Colorado State adjusts to that ride. And now defenders for CSU again have to pull back and try to force an empty possession by Utah Valley. Wolverines have the 1-0 lead after the Chad Renslow goal at 11-10. Mulligan with good defense on the far side there. You saw Mulligan 32 trying to chase. There's Dylan Widos, the goaltender. Love that sharp look of that Tech shirt underneath with the Aggies on the bottom side. Looks good. Widos all the way to center line, sends it deep downfield, and McFerrin can't get to it. A lot of the little things. Slightly off for the Rams. We isolate in on McFerrin, who's chasing the play. And here's a familiar look. Utah Valley operating in the attack area. Bounce shot attempt doesn't get through defenders. Willows reacts nicely. So Widows with the ball within his goalie circle, able to get to it. And let's see what CSU can do. Well, here's one way to solve it. Mulligan on his wheels. Low to Flores. Mulligan goes off to your screen to the left. Midi subs. And we'll see what Colorado State will do here. Down one goal with about 6 minutes left in the first quarter. You see car lights in the background here on campus. The lights are on up above us as well. Center cutter coming through. That is Parker McAnally. And the ball is popped out of his stick head to where you see that battle along the center line. And that'll be a turnover forced by the defense of Utah Valley. Head coach Brian Barnhill has to like the work of his guys really all over the field right now. Until then, McDonald with the long pull up ahead. And again, turned over. So Utah Valley clearing into the attack area. Flag falls to the ground on the right side of your screen. You can see it. And we'll have our first special team situation coming up. Second. Okay, it is the second special teams. We had an offsides call earlier in the game. And right now, so man up will be Utah Valley. Now we get the go whistle and a tight shot of Chad Renslow, who has the lone goal in the contest. As you look at Widows, the goalie, orchestrating the D-men in front of him. Widows reacting to that shot high and above his left shoulder. Widows seems dialed in. He's had a good run here. He was in net for the wins over Washington and number 22 Florida State here in Fort Collins. Utah Valley remains man up. And now we're back to even strength. I'm glancing across the field. But Utah Valley keeping possession with under four to play in the first quarter. And there is a pass across the field. It doesn't work out for the Wolverines. McDonald goes to get it, and Colorado State will try to clear. Ebers looking for help. It's intercepted at midfield. And then Colorado State chases it down. Widows sends it forward. Shane O'Brien. Well, pardon me, it's a 47. That's Nils Holland bringing it up. So good work by Nils Holland. We're starting to see some different numerals out there. That's Cade Ebers up front. The freshman sending it low to McFerrin and working it around. Now you've got Matthew Dowden working at X position back there behind the goal. Dowden has been extremely hot since he's been inserted midseason. CSU trying to weave cutters. McFerrin sees ball down, scoops it up. There's Braden Kono. To Flores, who takes the shot, and it's stopped. Put back opportunity by McFerrin is also blocked by Sturgill. And the pass from Flores to Dowden is off and out of bounds. And another turnover. As we tighten in on Matthew Dowden, the freshman has been so good. Fresh out of Minnesota. Been red hot, four goals against Washington just 3 days ago. About a minute and a half left, first quarter. One goal lead for Utah Valley. They take that shot from the near side, coming off the stick of Zach Fankhauser. Not much threat to Dylan Widows. Lone goal, Chad Renslow at 11-10. And the Wolverines will work it around again. Another stop by Dylan Widows. And there are those who watch the Washington game who have seen that look. Widows is still on one knee right now. And this is a goalie who had to pull himself out in the Washington game 3 days ago with a very familiar look. Yep, immediately getting attended to by Nolan Hector. And they're going to go behind the stanchion there and have him, well, adjust himself, is what it is. Trying to dance around it. Look, we're not going to be PC about it. He took one in the groin. It was a stop made against Washington. He went to the bushes on the other side of the field and then pulled himself out. Well, now we have the same situation. He just made a save and is now attending to himself. Brian Gross is now in goal for CSU. Under a minute left in the first quarter. Wolverines with the 1-0 lead. Oh, great reaction by McDonald forcing the turnover. Here comes Noah Miller, the D-man. And a great job by the former East Angel. And now we have a timeout called. Ryan McDonald, the head coach for Colorado State, wants to talk things out with his guys for this final 35 seconds. We're going to stay right here, considering the minimal time left in the first quarter, and get a look in on Ryan McDonald right there with the familiar vest. Only one time has Mother Nature forced McDonald to actually wear a coat. So he's got vest and then the pumpkin Aggie orange tech shirt underneath, and he's talking it out with his guys. Right now, there's one goal scored, Chad Renslow at 11-10 for Utah Valley. Let's go ahead and take a peek at this crazy sequence here where McFerrin jumped in the air, kind of a reverse spin, sent it towards Max Sturgill, who made the save. And now we go over to the Utah Valley bench And somewhere in there is head coach Brian Barnhill. Let's go ahead and take a peek at the lone tally in this contest. And I just gave you the summary on that one. That was at 11-10 first quarter. Here it is in the middle. Makes the turn. Kind of a twizzler. Chad Renslow. So the senior out of Pleasant Grove, Utah, has the only goal in the game, and Utah Valley has a very slim 1-0 lead in a low-scoring contest. Colorado State will have possession, so these guys on screen will have to defend for another 35 seconds at most. Can Colorado State even things up before we switch over to the second quarter? As you look at head coach Ryan McDonald once again. And we begin play after the timeout. Springer's out there, cradling left and looking to dodge and get back to the inside. Over to Flores and Chastain. CSU has time with 20 seconds left. Chastain takes the shot with the left over the shoulder and scores. Well, there's your answer. Effective timeout, Ryan McDonald and coaching staff. The Rams have evened things up. And let's take a look at the FanView replay. Chastain gets to the top side. Sends it with high velocity. Nick can shoot. Nick just scored. And we are even at 1-1. And we should note, Chastain also can absorb some contact. Took what perhaps could be considered a cross check to the backside. Most important part, Chastain scores at the 12-second mark as we count down the final seconds. Cobra's got it right now. Can they get a shot off? They do, and score. Well, that works, and that fits. There's the airplane celly from Cole Cobra. He gets the ground ball. He leads his squad in that statistic. And he also has the most points for his team as you look at the replay. Get it, go forward, send it, and score. Cole Cobra for Colorado State. One tick, and then we'll flip quarters. Well, how things changed in just 30 seconds as you look at the CSU Rams react and celebrate with how they finished off that quarter. Utah Valley scored first, but then Nick Chastain and Cole Colber send balls in, and now the Rams have a 2-1 lead as we take our first timeout in between quarters. Okay, we are back here for the second quarter. And now we get the scorebook up on the screen. We've just about 10 seconds into the second quarter here. What a change occurred in the back end of the first. We'll call it the final 12 seconds where Nick Chastain and Cole Colber scored for CSU. So it's the guys in white with the Rams have the 2-1 lead as Chastain is operating through the interior and multiple Utah Valley defenders. Colorado State's going to keep possession. That is Matthew Dowden back there for Max. So the Rams have some momentum, not just to even it up with the Chastain goal, but then the ground ball pickup by Cole Colber, and then he sends one in with one tick on the clock remaining in the first quarter. There's a look at Max Sturgill. He's already proven, yeah, he's pretty good in net. Goalie of the week in the Men's Collegiate Lacrosse Association. We've flipped sides, so Utah Valley in the dark jerseys with the dark green helmets are now moving left to right, and they have possession in the attack area. Errant pass, will it roll out of bounds? Yes, it does. So a turnover. That and the one goal lead was what we saw Utah Valley really having being more favored for most of that first quarter. And then things have changed as CSU attempts to clear with the long throw downfield, and it trickles into Moby Arena. Oh, nice clear by Utah Valley. Truman Peterson working on his own all the way around. And then a whistle blown. CSU bench calls for an offside. Well, Colorado State has possession. Widows all the way downfield. That's not going to work. Long stick, Seth Wilkins brings it all the way up for Utah Valley. Then it's popped loose. So a lot of herky-jerky moments here in the second quarter as we're just about 2 minutes and 15 seconds into the second. 2-1 lead for CSU. Wind up, go whistle, and here comes Utah Valley. That was a look at Braden Hudson. Now they send it down low. Back up top. Right wing. Widow saves it. It goes off his right fist. And then goes out of bounds. So as I call out Widows, he has attended to himself and done a good job. He's back out there. What a tough kid. He's gone out twice now in the last two games because he's made saves and absorbed impact to his groin. Widows just makes the save with his fist. And now you see him, what a great shot of him, set up between his pipes. Shot coming through. I think it deflected off a defender. And that was off the local kid, stick. That was Nate Huntsman, sophomore from Windsor. Unable to score, though. Intercepted down low. That was that Dowden? No, it was Mulligan. Well, that's why he's an All-American candidate. And here comes Colorado State. Nice wheels by Kate Vanek. Curling around as Flores. But a nice stop by Max Sturgill. Think Sturgill's probably seen some tape on number four. One of the better goal scorers, certainly in the Rocky Mountain Lacrosse Conference, if not the whole country. You can see Riley Flores centered there, right behind Matthew Dowden, who's now up top on a near wing. There's Dowden trying to receive that pass attempt, and it goes out of bounds, Utah Valley ball. Wolverines in the black uniforms trailing now by one. They held a one-goal lead for 11 minutes in that first quarter until the Nick Chastain and Cole Colbert goals. Ball taken away, Blaine Ware. Colbert sends it low to high, and it is off. Trying to show you Cole Colbert, the senior captain. Right now he has the go-ahead goal. That was with 1 second left in the first quarter. And here comes Utah Valley once again. Ashton Matheny is number six, and that's Matheny, Hina's brother. A couple of starters. Big brother Kimball is a sophomore middie for Utah Valley. And a pause in the action, tighten in on the officiating crew. Utah Valley's going to have possession. I believe. I'm watching the head coaches and now trying to get a read on it. Yes, it'll be Wolverine's ball. And you might have seen Cale Kissel walk right by that head official. It's going to be a man-up situation for Utah Valley. So third time in this game, Utah Valley is man up, and they're down one goal. That shot coming through to Widows, and he couldn't seal it to the ground, but it pops up in the air, and Noah Miller snatches it out of the air. Nice reaction by Noah Miller. And here's that aggressive ride once again. Utah Valley pulling guys up, and CSU reacting by longer throws downfield. It's not working out in that case. Wolverines have the ball again. Still man up. Shot is wide. It caroms off the stick head of Dylan Widows and goes far out of bounds. And now we're back to even strength. As we look in on Kissel across the way, always have to point out he is a native from the farm. Give our shout outs to Wheat Ridge on the northwest side of Metro Denver. Working inside. Did he get the goal? No, it's waved off, crease violation. Athletic attempt by Tyler Hawes, but it is waved off. Here comes Kevin Mulligan and Colorado State as we move right to left. A save by Max Sturgill. Ooh, goalies are hot right now. And that shows on the scoreboard as well. Inside, off the post. And it bounces all the way down. Cale Kissel is now moving downfield into the attack area. And a goal by Matthew Dowden plus the flag. To keep an eye on if that's a flagrant two-minute foul. The goal's going to stand. Matthew Dowden scores again. How much has he done in the last 3 weeks? Here it is, just cranks it and then sends it by Sturgill and then takes a shot to his face mask. Matthew Dowden at 8:32 in the second quarter has given CSU a two-goal advantage. And you look at the reaction there by Brian Barnhill, the seven-year head coach for Utah Valley. We appreciate Brian Barnhill immediate sharing when we're doing our broadcast preparation work. So willing to share with us stuff about his Utah Valley squad so we can try to do our best to professionally present them as well as our home crew, Colorado State. The call is a shot to the head that will be a two-minute penalty against Utah Valley. So Matthew Dowden scores at 8:32, and now Colorado State will get to keep that momentum in a man-up situation as you look at head coach Ryan McDonald getting the verdict explained to him by the officiating crew. full 2 minutes locked in regardless of who scores when. Again, I'm sourcing Patrick Sullivan, who is a former coach and defensive All-American with Colorado State, helping us out with the explanations. We'll look again at that shot and the infraction. And you see the official was standing right there. Really no hiding it, no dressing it up. I'm letting it breathe so maybe you can read the lips of the officiating crew. So the referees want some time added back on, and I think they've executed that function. We have 8:39 on our score bug, and we have resumed play. So again, reset what we're doing right now. Matthew Dowden just scored, 8:32 second quarter. Rams have a two-goal lead, and their man up, locked in two-minute violation against Utah Valley. Ooh, I thought that was a doorstep opportunity coming up for Riley Flores, but missed connection there on the pass attempt. And it's taken away by Max Sturgill. Enjoying the play of the freshman goaltender. Both these guys, Dylan Widdows as well. Springer sending a shoulder into the advancing Wolverine. That's Patrick Fletcher. So Utah Valley killing off some time here in this two-minute man down situation for them. And they're down two goals. And again, the recall of the first quarter where Utah Valley looked so sharp and held a one-goal lead for about 11 minutes in that opening quarter. And look at this as you look across the way at Braden Hudson, still on one knee. He's not coming out yet. And Alec Banton's just going to stand there with Malcolm McDonald hawking him. Is that Kate Vanek, 56? Yep, it's Vanek. And then a big hit coming from behind, and the crowd reacts to the physical play of Jordan Cutter. Flores looking for help. Nobody there. Reset. Still man up. Colorado State with the two-goal advantage. Under seven to play here in the first half. Careful, Dowden. That's the turf monster. Thirty seconds left remaining in the man up for Colorado State. Patiently taking their time with their two-goal lead. And then we have a whistle stoppage. And if you look across the way and center in, there's Ryan McDonald. The official is just to his right. Let's take a peek at the hit by Jordan Cutter. Watch this. Oh, boom. There he is. Yep, keep your head on a swivel. Watch your backside. And still talk amongst the officials with about 6 minutes left here in the second quarter. We're back to even strength. But Colorado State has possession. As I try to get a read and try to share with you details that you may need. Parker McAnally operating, takes the left-hand sidearm shot, and that is wide. Here's the chase. Flores can't get there nearest. And you look at the official also transitioning. That there's a hint right there. Zebras on the sprint. Must be a change of possession. As Utah Valley tries to clear.
Truman Peterson does a nice job, but then he's attacked from behind. A steal by Cale Kissel, and now he's moving. Wheels, 10, looking for somebody. Found McAnally, and he'll peel back. Five and a half left, second quarter. The guys in white on their home turf, Colorado State with the two-goal advantage. Three unanswered goals for CSU. Dowden, Coburn, and Chastain. And there's Nick Chastain right there. Bounce shot attempt saved by Sturgill. And here comes Utah Valley. Over the top of the defense. Ball down and no turnover. Nice hustle across the way by Tyler Hawes. Under five left in the first half. And look at the aggressive defense of CSU coming up on the ball. That shot from far out, saved by Widows. Picks the ball up and sends it downfield, and here comes Kevin Mulligan. And a score. Well, Kevin Mulligan gets the assist and the left-hand wrister from Jared McFerrin. And you look at the replay. Mulligan, McFerrin, laser into the twine, and Colorado State has now scored four unanswered goals and a timeout called. And you know who likes it? The Outlaws of CSU are in the house. And there's Jared McFerrin, 1-5 centered on your screen, celebrating with his teammates. Jared McFerrin's parents are here, and we'll take a break during this timeout. Three-goal lead for CSU. And this is a field of academia. Hashtag student athletes. You look at that. You got the students across the way studying and perhaps faking it on our screens. They see the red lights. Act like you're doing something. Meantime, okay, lights are off. Let's watch this outstanding top 25 lacrosse action between Utah Valley and Colorado State. Got to love those shots. Again, Phil Mildren and his crew, Justin Salvia, Johnny Houston, Zach Johnson, Mike Trujillo are operating the big rig cameras. Marty Cesario in here with Patrick Sullivan. Honored, privileged, excited, sort of like a fanboy, digging the lacrosse here in Fort Collins. 4-1 lead for Colorado State, four unanswered goals. Most recently, Jared McFerrin at 4:19 in the second quarter. Contact head-to-head. And a ground ball pickup by Gabe Fankhauser. Jordan Cutter able to get a hold of the ball. That's good because he's the one who took the shot to the head. And then more contact across the way. Tough guys out there. And you know what I like? No whistles. You know what you signed up for. There's Jordan Cutter being attended to. He's another one of the Rams players who's part of a mid-year evolution where head coach Ryan McDonald had to shuffle around personnel because of injuries and other things. And then you've seen some different guys develop, step up, and do so many great things. Jordan Cutter is certainly one of those guys. 26 has compelled us to call his name out often in the last 2-3 weeks. Approaching that 3-minute mark remaining in the first half, Colorado State in white with possession. That's Kono scoring. Braden Kono wants to get in on the action, so let's put him on the board. How about the work of the junior from El Dorado Hills, California? Check the replay and showcase number 3 for the Rammies. Kono gets over the top of the defender from way up high, far right wing, and his teammates love that. It's a 5-1 lead for the Rams. 2:52 mark, second quarter. Ryan McDonald is now strutting along the sidelines with confidence as Braden Kono just scored. And a faceoff win, and here comes Cade Kissel. He takes the shot, a nice save by Max Sturgill. Flores with the ground ball. Six total goals, six combined goal scores in this game. Most recently, Braden Kono at 2:52. Something changed in the last 30 seconds of that first quarter, and since then, it's been a whole lot of CSU. That's Dowden to Flores. Over here, a shot from Chastain, saved by Sturgill. So we tighten in on Nick Chastain. Chastain scored his 15th goal here in the first half, 15th goal of the season. Kober has also scored. He's got 17 on the year. And one gets through from Riley Flores. Great job by the Rams, cycling the ball around. Near wing, they find Flores, and he was ready to almost one-time it. A quick stick from the near side, from that far out. Boom! There goes Riley Flores. So all the big money players are stepping up here in the second quarter for the Rammies, including that guy, Riley Flores. .139 mark. Second quarter, Riley Flores scores his first. And possession awarded to Parker McAnally and Colorado State. That's Springer down low. Trying to get a read on what he's waiting to develop. McAnally has possession, being defended well by Bryce Anthon. That's Kono using a screen. And some excellent defense reacting by Utah Valley, forcing Kono to lose the ball momentarily. And a timeout called? Yes. Nope, that's a timeout called with about a minute left here in this game. Six unanswered goals by CSU. We'll take a quick pause and come right back and see what the Rams can do with the ball. Hang on. Thank you. Onside director Justin Salvia says we're going to get a cool shot of the Rams huddle, and that's what you're looking at right here. Head coach Ryan McDonald right in the middle. CSU will have the ball after that Riley Flores goal about 30 seconds ago. These guys trying to make a stop here and perhaps get one in before the end of the half. Utah Valley has had the scenario, the story of this game just flipped on them. And it all started with a Nick Chastain goal with 12 seconds left in the first quarter, to where we all reacted with, okay, CSU got even. But then Cole Colber picked up a ground ball and put one in with 1 second left in that first quarter, and suddenly CSU was in command, and it stayed that way here throughout the second quarter. And the Rams have the ball right now. Some good physical defense back there by Bryce Anthem, the sophomore from Bountiful, Utah. Leads to a turnover. And a clear by Ashton Matheny. Matheny's going to come through, and he's going to score. Well, his dad, pretty pumped, because he's here on site. Matheny clearing all on his own and continued to progress down through the attack area. As you look at the replay, decided to take the shot and got one through Dylan Widdows. The freshman D-mid, Ashton Matheny, scores for Utah Valley with 33 seconds remaining in the first half. Ball in the air, under 30 seconds left. Kissel's just on the ball and now a flag. Delayed penalty in effect. Kissel waves bye-bye. Utah Valley goes to get it, and now we'll see what's going on with the flag. It's going to be a man up for CSU. Slashing call is what our crew is assuming. So we do still have some time left remaining in the second quarter. As Cole Colber is going to bring it forward. And in this case, he's going to have to circle around. And that will be the end of the second quarter. The Rams will use that when we resume play in the third. So how about the Rams? Six unanswered goals. Chastain Colber, Dowden McFerrin, Kono Flores. Matheny sent one in for Utah Valley, but it's the Rammies who are now in control as we take the intermission break. At half, CSU leads 6-2.
That's who we're thinking of when we're doing it.
I know. But remote. Now I flew in to see these.
She's like, I'm going to go say hello to Marty. I'm like, okay.
That's awesome. Thank you. So is this one of your
PJ.
Marty. Oh, perfect. Oh, okay. So are you guys still Rocky or are you PSU?
Supposed to be Rocky this year, but
really? So I may have it like my daughter plays. She's got PSU. Yeah.
Well, back to the action here at 8.05 p.m. Mountain Time. Number 16, Utah Valley, in the dark uniforms. They're on the road and trailing 21st-ranked Colorado State after two quarters of play. Marty Cesario here in Fort Collins on the broadcast, along with the outstanding Super Bad production crew with FanView, including Phil Mildren, Justin Salvia, Johnny Houston, Mike Trujillo, Zach Johnson. So what happened in that first half of play as we approached the third quarter? Well, Utah Valley started out strong, had a much cleaner way of operating and executing. They had an aggressive ride where they were not allowing CSU to clear effectively at all. Utah Valley scored that first goal at 11-10 with Chad Renslow and then held that lead for quite a while. And then six unanswered goals by Colorado State. It all started with Nick Chastain scoring with 12 seconds left in the first, and Cole Kober then getting the ground ball and the shot off to score with 1 second left in the first. That began the momentum change, along with other adjustments by that gentleman, Ryan McDonald, who seems to be fired up, right, as we just get started here in the third quarter. Four-goal advantage for CSU. We mentioned the momentum that the Rams have. Now, we should note that the most recent goal tally was Ashton Matheny, the defensive middie for Utah Valley. Well, that's a good start for CSU. Across the way, Cole Kober has scored his second of the game just 20 seconds in to the third quarter. So a good start for the Rams. As I note that, regardless of all the scoring, six unanswered for CSU, it's actually Utah Valley who had the recent goal. Well, Cole Kober shuts me up and gets things started here in the second half. Cole Kober at 14:41 here in the third to get the Rams back up to a five-goal advantage. And that is Cole Kober's second of the game. So he is the only multi-goal scorer so far. As you see, a nice ground ball pickup by the faceoff specialist for Utah Valley. That was Austin Doyle, who trades time with Connor Boss. So applaud the work of 24 in the meantime. A lot of opportunities on the ground ball and eventually scooped up by long stick Noah Miller. Trying to get a read on who eventually got the ground ball. Meantime, Dylan Widows coming across center line, and now he's retreating. You just saw on the screen. So McFerrin's operating with the ball, and CSU is setting up after scoring in the first 20 seconds. Here's Flores. Creates some space for himself to get the shot off. Riley Flores right there, number four, able to get that shot off. It is wide of the goal, but Dowden's nearest, so CSU's going to keep it. Kober swimming through, ducking, sends it through, saved by Sturgill. Both you guys showcase highlight moments. Wow. That's as good of a non-scoring highlight from two different guys that you'll see. Kober operating with the ball, and then Sturgill with a nice save. Utah Valley in the dark uniforms. They have possession. They are down five until now. And it is Chad Renslow scoring his second of the game. So big money players are stepping up here in the third, and that includes that guy. Chad Renslow, the senior attack for Utah Valley. Let's check the replay. Nothing fancy. Runs away from the D and then sends it with the left sidearm shot. 22 Chad Renslow, 13:06 in the third quarter. And the Wolverines are back to within four. Possession awarded to CSU. The Renslow goal really begs us to state the obvious. These are really good teams. Don't trust any lead. Got to stay sharp until we finish up.
That's Dowden back there. McFerrin sends it high and this way. Ebers bouncing around up top. He takes the shot, and that goes off the stick head of Sturgill. There's a look at Kate Ebers. Ebers does so many good things for CSU when they're in the attack. Back there, Dowden, trying to leverage his way across the goal line. He does, but then the ball's knocked loose by some excellent defense of Utah Valley. Delayed flag. And here comes Utah Valley and the clear. Keaton Stevens stops there and leans and throws it downfield. So there's two flags on the field right now with Utah Valley still having possession. And we'll stay that way on the delay. Shot coming through the Widows. He makes the save, and then the refs stop the game, and we'll see what's going on here. You see the defense talking it out, McDonald and Noah Miller. Officiating staff discussing. What's your flag? What's your flag? Already can tell off screen, one Ram will be on one knee. There you go, right on cue. Mike and Zach aren't going to miss anything on camera. That's Matthew Dowden. There's a good look. Riley Flores cradling the flag. Waxing like a hobo. But then being a good boy, handing over the flag to the official, and we will have a man-up situation for Utah Valley. Well, it's timely for Utah Valley. Just scored, have the ball. That doesn't get through. I think it deflected off of one of the defenders. Maybe it was Jake Niss back there, 21. There's Cale Kissel ISOing on him for a moment. Right up front, and a quick stick goal for Nate Huntsman. So the local kid with his dad here on site, Mark Huntsman and the family are here. Nate Huntsman, the former Windsor Wizard, able to get a goal for his Utah Valley Wolverines, and here's the replay. Just good exchanges with the ball, eventually finding a cutting 13, Nate Huntsman, as Utah Valley reacts. And, of course, the head coach, not as much. Brian Barnhill stoically drawing up what the next plans are. 11:03, third quarter, man up. Nate Huntsman scores for Utah Valley. The last two goals have been scored by the Wolverines. The crowd reacting to all the contact through the interior as Dylan Huff gets the ground ball off the faceoff win. Now a familiar look is the clear from Remington Peterson is executed along with Patrick Fletcher. Kimball Matheny. And over across the way as Utah Valley sets up. So some modest momentum for the Wolverines. They've scored the last two here in the third. Nate Huntsman scored 30 seconds ago, roughly, in the man up for Utah Valley, and they're within three. Twice Utah Valley has been down by as many as five goals. And now they're within two. And a hat trick for Chad Renslow. who's finding multiple ways to attack the defense of CSU. Let's look at the replay here. Chad Renslow. Really nothing fancy on that, too. Defender was late getting to him to challenge the shot attempt, and Chad Renslow has scored again for Utah Valley. As you look at 7-year head coach Brian Barnhill once again in his reaction. .951 mark, third quarter. That was Chad Renslow scoring again. And we have a two-goal game. Well, certainly Utah Valley has regained the attention of Colorado State. It's a two-goal game after the Renslow goal at 9:51. Renslow has a hat trick. And the ball rolls out of bounds on the near side as you get a good look at how many fans are here. Oh, that's great. MCLA action. We've seen it throughout the course of the year. People coming to support both squads. Of course, Utah Valley, their community traveling over the Continental Divide to come here to Northern Colorado to support their guys. Shot attempt coming through the middle there, doesn't get through, and now a ground ball battle, and Huntsman able to pick it up. Fair to say the Wolverines have regained some confidence. Put three in within 3 minutes of each other, that'll do it. Up top, Ashton Matheny, he's got a goal in this game. Down to X. And back up top to Burbage. Preston Burbage going no-look pass to the far side. And then instead of sending a shot, Renslow tries to hit a cutter, and it goes out of bounds. And then we get a look at the Colorado State community. So see how many fans are out here. I don't have official attendance figures coming in. As Malcolm McDonald, spin move, long pull, clears. Take the shot, and he does. Malcolm McDonald has scored the long pull goal. And that is a showcase highlight that he can send to Grandmama. Wow. And let's rewind all the way back. Watch this. 5-8 operating. And finishing. 7:40 mark, third quarter. As the Outlaws, with that sheepish grin, enjoying the work of Malcolm McDonald. That's right, uh-huh. You like that. Hashtag Grand Pride. And now the Outlaws forcing me to make post-production notes. Malcolm McDonald, long pole goal, followed by Outlaws fronting the camera. That'll work. Well, it's not only the flashiness of the McDonald goal, but the timeliness, too. Utah Valley had scored three in a row. And then you get a play like that from a defense, from a defensive middle. Is that a score by Utah Valley? They're celebrating. It does get through. So the Wolverines with the quick counter. That's Preston Burbage celebrating. I didn't get a read on who scored, and we will not get a replay on that because that was an odd goal score. We can mark it down at 6:58. Third quarter, Utah Valley scores again, and they are within two again. we are hearing through the crowd, go Ty. Maybe it's Tyler Hawes who's credited with that goal. I'll go ahead and mark down a 21 with an asterisk. And maybe in between quarters I can confirm if it was Tyler Hawes who scored. That would fit because he's an attackman. Maybe he was up front in the mix. Either way, 6:58 third quarter. Good answer by Utah Valley following up the Malcolm McDonald score, and we're back to a two-goal game here in the third. We're all looking at each other. So the officials set the ball right there at midfield, and we'll have a face-off, perhaps a lack of clarity on who to award possession. Face-off win CSU. Here comes Kober up the middle, and it's a save by Sturgill. Good clear on the part of Patrick Fletcher. And Fletcher will go off to the right of your screen. Midi subs coming in. Utah Valley down two. Six minutes now remaining, third quarter. Wolverines taking their time. And there's plenty of that left in this game. Trying to go with that radical angle attempt from the far side as we look at River Hansen. And it doesn't get through. I think it went behind the cage. Utah Valley is going to keep possession, which is why you're seeing those reactions by Hansen. He's staying in play in the attack area. And bouncing back, there's Nate Huntsman. So Huntsman moving down low to X position. No cutter, it's stolen away by McDonald. Here comes Malcolm. And McFerrin. And now CSU will reset. More big plays defensively by Malcolm McDonald, and then he scores as well. Here comes CSU. Trying to leave it. And miscommunication there leads to Utah Valley clearing it out. Keaton Stevens gives it to Burbage. Utah Valley setting up down two goals with about 4.5 left third quarter. Number 16, Utah Valley, trailing by two to 21st ranked Colorado State. The turn and the shot by Renslow, and a good reaction by the goaltender, Dylan Widows. Long throw downfield, Blaine Ware can't get to it. It was there. And there's Blaine Ware, another local kid, played for Mountain Vista. You hear all the talking across the way and the reacting. Many times you don't need me to say a word. Just listen and you can tell what's going on. Vanek pushing it down low to Springer and then back up top to McFerrin. Vanek's going to stay in front of the crease there, and now he'll slowly move out of the picture. Yep, there's Vanek hustling off. And Colorado State will settle in on how they're going to operate here.
So Dowden's high. You see McFerrin low. Springer's on the backside of that cage. And now they rotate to where McFerrin's back to that X spot. Who's going to make the cut? Kober's shot is deflected by a defender, and it goes out of bounds. CSU's going to keep it. There's Springer back there. Good to have Springer back. Dowden trying to battle for the ball, and that's a good reaction to it. Jace Muir, and Muir clears. Now we have a ground ball, midfield. Muir picks it up again. This has been a grind. We've seen a lot of that. You could call it sloppy, or maybe it's just a challenging game. And a score by Utah Valley. Zach Fankhauser has pulled the Wolverines to within one goal. It's almost like CSU lost him back there. And we'll look at it. Film don't lie. Ooh. And Widows had to come across. Zach Fankhauser didn't waste any time whatsoever. The sophomore from Draper, Utah, scores. And suddenly the looks of Brian Barnhill are changing, as Utah Valley has been picking up goals here in this third quarter. 2:25 mark. In the third, Fankhauser pulls the Wolverines to within one. And we'll have a timeout called with about 2 minutes left. Pause in the action. These guys in white, they're being challenged. We'll take a break. There's a solid look. Future WLAX player right there. Mm-hmm. That's fun. Scorekeeper. Then we tilt up, get a wider shot. CSU's already broken their huddle, and now Utah Valley coming out. Utah Valley has scored 5 of the last 6 goals, all in this third quarter. We went to halftime break with CSU having a 6-2 lead. They extended that lead to 7-2. But again, 5 of the last 6 goals recorded by the Wolverines from Utah Valley University. Colorado State looking to come out sharply after their timeout. And that wouldn't be it. And now a challenge for the Rams defense as Utah Valley brings it upfield, looking to tie this game up. Can the Wolverines get to it? They did not. And you see the reaction by the CSU reserves across the way. Under 90 seconds remaining in the third. Rammies on their heels. Look how high Widows is. As CSU tries to clear, they send it all the way downfield again with the long throw.
bodies hit the turf, and Utah Valley's going to have it. Wolverines trying to get out of there and clear. No luck. Ty Armstrong bringing it up. Nice backside trailing defense. Cale Kissel, how many times does he do things like that for us on screen? Here comes Colorado State. Kevin Mulligan is going to bounce around to the near side. Take his time. You can hear through the crowd mics, Nate Huntsman calling ball. He's got ball. Good communication by the Utah Valley defense as Kono waits for Parker McAnally to come in. And there's Parker right there. Parker's dad's in the house, came over and said hello. We appreciate those things. Subbing in a timely fashion was Nils Holland. And CSU will continue to operate. What can McAnally do as he pushes along the goal line there? Final 10 seconds of the third quarter. Flores tries to send one through, but the defense of Utah Valley disallows the shot. And we have the horn. Now there's a reaction of Riley Flores. CSU has some talking amongst themselves to do. Five of the last six scored by their opponents, number 16, Utah Valley. Fourth quarter coming up. Hang on. Look at the crowd here. You know, I'll be honest with you, just for a visual, I'm inside a sport tent down at field level along with Patrick Sullivan. So, yeah, there's our tent. Boy, you guys are so good. Matter of fact, let's see if I can stick my hand out. There you go. All right. So we didn't really have a read on how many people are here. What a great showing by both these communities. There are a lot of folks watching this really good lacrosse game between two top 25 squads, and you can hear the volume starting to amp up. And right on cue, the fanatics on the sidelines are ready for at minimum another 15 minutes of lacrosse within the top 25. Let's do this. And a good physical battle for a ground ball. CSU takes it. Cole Colber swimming through two defenders. We've switched sides, reset visually. In white with the bighorn lids, that's Colorado State. Defending in black, that is Utah Valley. It's a one goal game. CSU has the lead, but the Wolverines of UVU have scored five of the last six. So Dowden is low again. Colber over on a near wing. Fading, looking for a cutter. Nobody's there. Utah Valley defending well. And now the Wolverines trying to clear. They do so. Keaton Stevens advancing forward. They tried to find Renslow. But Jake Niss denied that shot opportunity as we dial in on Malcolm McDonald. So Widows is going to bring it up. He's been aggressive tonight on the clear. Mulligan takes one to the shoulder. Sends it down. Holland forward. Thought maybe Nils Holland might take that shot. Instead, they'll set up the offense. And a save by Sturgill. Perhaps the Rams trying to catch Sturgill off guard there. Not going to be the case. 2 minutes into the fourth quarter. It's a one-goal game. Utah Valley in the dark uniforms trying to tie things up here. Keep an eye on 22 Renslow. He's got a hat trick in this game for Utah Valley. He's down low off screen. Cale Kissel knocks the ball loose. And now there's a battle and chaos at center line. There's number 10, Cale Kissel, in the picture. Just making plays, baby. Now who's going to get possession of the ball? Yep, it's Utah Valley. So the Wolverines are awarded possession. Here they go. Gotta love these competitive top 25 games. We're past all the details and scene setting. Boys playing for W's. Noah Miller being aggressive on D, getting help from McDonald. Niss sends a player to the turf. Oh yeah, the guys are bringing the noise across the way. And then a buzz kill, a whistle. But CSU likes it. Offsides call. Oh, shot clock expires, so credit the defense of CSU for holding without a single shot on goal. And look at that nifty work by Cale Kissel. And he scores. Make the move, hop through the D from across the straining line. Cale Kissel scores for Colorado State, and the Outlaws dig that as well. Oops, lost somebody. Go ahead. Yeah, number 10, get yourself a goal. 11:27 mark, fourth quarter. Cale Kissel scores for Colorado State. I'm going to need a pretty good modern rock music bed with beats to handle all the showcase highlights we're going to have to do in post-production. McDonald, Kissel, long pulls, sending it in. Good stuff. Both these squads giving us the entertainment of CSU pushing forward. Maybe they've regain some momentum for themselves. Utah Valley had scored five of the last six, but Cale Kissel just scored at 11:27 here in the fourth. It's a two-goal lead again for CSU. The Rams have led by as many as five in this game. Chastain to the inside. And a nice save by Sturgill. Hit the crossbar, which is why you get that reaction. So it went through Sturgill, but
Sturgill turns around and thanks the pipe. Hit the post again, and look at the ball carom all the way to midfield. Boy, that back end sharp for CSU. There were three different guys running after the ball after it caromed off the pipe to center line. Cole Colbert has it, sent it across the way. Two goal game, 5 minutes into the fourth. And CSU being patient now. Dowden is way up high. A sidearm shot that the crowd was awaiting from Dowden, the freshman who does have a goal in the game. He had four goals in the win over Washington 3 days ago. Springer tries to spin and catch that young man, Sturgill, off guard. Not going to happen. 9.5 remaining in the game. A pause in the action. Some discussion between officials. As we look in on that officiating crew, again noting that they had got caught in a car accident before the game. We thought maybe we'd have a delay in the start, but they hustled over here and got us going on time. So thank you to them, and we applaud their effort. 8:43 Mountain Time, deep in the darkness. CSU with a two-goal lead. They have the ball and can't get a shot off. Physical D forces the ground ball. Good sweep by Utah Valley. Ashton Matheny trying to pick it up. It eventually got to it. That's Jace Muir. Across the way, nearly intercepted by Jake Niss. Niss trying to scoop it up, kicks it, pushes it. Contact, 3v3. Bodies hitting the deck. And the ground ball by Malcolm McDonald, and he sends it all the way downfield. CSU will settle down and get the score. Look at the celebration by Cade Vanek. Row, 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 row. Cade Vanek gets the goal, and Ryan McDonald gives him the love. Vanek steps up into the play and sidearms it through Sturgill. How about all the contributors tonight in the scoring column? McDonald, Kissel, and now Vanek, all in the second half. 8:35 mark, fourth quarter. Cade Vanek scores for CSU. Now the Rams have scored two in a row. And now we have a Wolverine who's down. Kissel goes to one knee. And you wonder when you see reactions by the opponents, you know, if they heard something, they know something. And we'll pause the action and wish the best for freshman Austin Doyle. Let's take a break here in Fort Collins.
Well, you see the medical staff from Orthopedic Center of the Rockies, locally involved with Colorado State Athletics, including their opponents in all sports, attending to the freshman, Austin Doyle. He's on his feet like that, but clearly he's affected and will wish nothing but a rapid recovery for Austin Doyle. Now we move around and see head coach Ryan McDonald. CSU has regained some momentum. They gave up five of the last six, all within the third quarter. Had their lead depleted to just a one-goal margin, but then Cale Kissel and Cade Vanek have scored within 3 minutes apart, and now CSU is back to a three-goal advantage as we resume play here in Fort Collins on campus. Nils Holland across the way. That's Holland continuing to work around and just expire some time. Under 8 minutes left here in the fourth. Appreciate you watching here on the FanView platforms. Whether you're from the Utah Valley community or Colorado State. Or maybe you're just an MCLA fan. Think you're getting your money's worth, and the money invested is nothing. Springer sent down to the ground. He did lose possession. Good quick pickup and scoop. And now here comes Utah Valley. Ashton Matheny has a goal in this game, just like that, and this time Widdows makes the save. He scored exactly that way back at the end of the second quarter. So Widdows gets a timely save with under seven left here in the fourth. That is Matheny. Roll dodge, gets across GLE, but getting no help whatsoever, and a great reaction by the defense. That's Parker McAnally, who delivered the contact. So a delayed penalty in effect. You can see a flag to the right of the screen. And now we'll stop play, and Utah Valley's going to go man up. McDonald, 50, that was Vanek actually, 56, going to chase the ball down. Maybe he didn't see the flag, but we are going to have a man up situation favoring the guys in the dark unis. Utah Valley trailing by three now, six and a half left. They'll have 60 seconds with a man advantage. Chad Renslow's to the right of the cage as we're looking at it. And a missed exchange across the way. Mullen's going to chase it down. And Kevin Mulligan taking his time. You see the aggressive ride of Utah Valley. Still man up. Over to the goalie Widdows. Shane O'Brien helps with a successful clear, and CSU will set up. That Springer up high now. It's been interesting based on what we've seen through the course of the season. A lot of changes in where those attackers have been parked in this game. And really, that's been the case the last two games. CSU looking for a third consecutive victory in this span of games, four games within 8 days, all in Fort Collins. They beat Florida State on Saturday. Defeated Washington 3 days ago, looking to get a dub against Utah Valley. Look at that double on defense. That works out well as Utah Valley goes to clear. Truman Peterson showing the wheels. Ball popped loose. Kober had it for a moment, and then he's sent to the ground. Malcolm McDonald picked it up. Kober gets off the ground and now trying to chase the ball down. There's all kinds of contact as Kober is trying to operate across the restraining line, and CSU loses possession. And here comes the Wolverines. We got a roller derby type of game here at CSU. Blaine Ware takes the shot, and it's saved by Max Sturgill. 4.5 left. Utah Valley trails by 3. Wolverines have the ball. Staff barking out orders as Utah Valley runs through their subs, and they set up. Kimball Matheny steps into the play. So Renlow is operating out of X, and he's going to stay behind the cage. Always keeping a read on where 2-2 is. Up front, making the turn. It doesn't get through. Saved by Widows. Scooped up by Niss. Good defense by Colorado State. And here comes Dylan Widows, the goalie. Well, they lost possession on that long throw downfield. About 3.5 left here. Utah Valley's going to bring it back the other way. Long pull coming through. Jackson Blackham marked by Malcolm McDonald. And we got a timeout call. I'm sitting in a lawn chair and leaning forward the whole time. This is good lacrosse entertainment. It's a 3-goal spread. We take a break here in Fort Collins. Well, again, a look at the crowd here. And, of course, they're not sitting. You've got no pulse if you're sitting right now. Or maybe you're a little chilly because we have dropped down to 45 degrees. It is still early springtime here in northern Colorado. As you look at head coach Brian Barnhill having a quick exchange with one of the officiating crew. His Wolverines, if they want to extend the game, have about 3.5 minutes left to score 3 goals. As we resume play. Vanek battles for it. Instead, Utah Valley comes up with it. Good hustle to the ball, Kendall Matheny. And eventually, Renslow comes out with it. So Renslow's back up high. And Dylan Widow steps into the play. They were trying to force a pass through the crease, and Widow steps into it and intercepts it. CSU has possession. About 3 minutes left. They have the 3-goal lead. And they score. Well, how about that? The All-American candidate, the D-mid, Kevin Mulligan, has scored for the Colorado State Rams. Let's watch this whole thing develop with 32 operating on the replay. The Golden Demon on the run, puts it through and scores the 11th goal of the night for the Colorado State Rams. There is Mulligan. 2:47 mark, fourth quarter. Kevin Mulligan is yet another non-attacker who scores for the CSU squad. Trying to think of the proper way to say that. Defensive personnel is a fair way to say it, and I'm sourcing the right guy, Patrick Sullivan, two-time All-American and former defensive coach with this program. Approaching that two-minute mark, the guys in white across the way still yelling, screaming, hyping up their teammates on the field, and the Rams have a four-goal lead. Wasn't that long ago that Utah Valley had creeped to within one. That was at the end of the third quarter. Just three goals scored here in the fourth, all by CSU, all by defensive personnel. I think I'm going to tweet it that way and credit Patrick Sullivan. Sully giving me the goods. Up front, great opportunity. Two pump fakes, and that's a goal for Utah Valley. That was real sharp. Tyler Hawes with the score for the Wolverines. Not much to do there if you're Dylan Widows. Doorstep opportunity, no help coming ever as you look at the replay. Matter of fact, the first player to step into the picture was wearing a dark uniform. And Tyler Hawes has scored at the 129 mark. Unofficially, that is Tyler Hawes' second goal of the game. I say unofficially, we had the one goal, we weren't sure what we saw. We unofficially credited him with that shot. So it's a three-goal game with 75 seconds remaining here in regulation. Kober spins around, and then it's taken away. Remington Peterson with some good work defensively. Utah Valley's got to get shots off. Under 1 minute left. Utah with possession. The turn, the shot, and it's swept aside by Dylan Widows. Utah Valley's going to keep it with under 45 seconds left. One comes through towards the crease, and Widows scoops it up, immediately transitioning. Blaine Ware over to Kono. And now CSU is going to kill clock. 25 seconds left. This was a big game coming in. BYU is ahead on Saturday, but this was the game where guys were going to find out just who they were. 16 versus 21 in the polls. Colorado State is celebrating. And that's it. Outlaws in the foreground, winners in back. Colorado State had their lead trimmed to just one going into the fourth quarter. Kissel, Vanek, Mulligan scored for the Rammies, and CSU is coming out with this with an 11-8 victory. Let's go ahead and look at the schedules, starting with head coach Brian Barnhill's Utah Valley squad. They still have Brigham Young ahead of them. They take the loss tonight, They play CU down in Boulder in 2 days. That's what's upcoming for Utah Valley. Colorado State, we look at their schedule. You see their string of wins now. They beat then number 22 Florida State, took care of business against Washington, just beat number 16 Utah Valley, and coming up on Saturday, inside Canvas Stadium, they'll take on Brigham Young, and then they got Michigan State ahead of them. So the schedule's not going to let up on the CSU Rams, but tonight, when it was, go ahead, show me some proof, the Rams got it done. And congratulations to head coach Ryan McDonald and his CSU men's lacrosse crew. So for our big bad producer Phil Mildren and his outstanding crew, including Justin Salvia, Johnny Houston, Zach Johnson, and Mike Trujillo, my name's Marty Cesario. Again, the final score, 11-8. The Rams score 3 from defensive personnel in the fourth quarter. And number 21 beats number 16. Congratulations to CSU. We say goodnight from Fort Collins.